We just left Leanne's and we're going to camp. I wish I didn't say at the end of the last video that things were a little weird, because now, of course, everybody wants to know what the weird was. Okay, the first... I don't know if this was weird, but I got a little cranky about it. When we showed up, Leanne more or less insisted that she had to park the bus for me because her driveway was, like, so hard to navigate into. And it wasn't a hard driveway. I mean, it had a telephone pole next to it. That's it. But, yeah, I mean, I drive this bus every day. It's a bus. It's not a van. A, it was not a hard driveway to get into. And B, no. No. It's my bus. You're not going to drive it. I parked in the driveway. Everything was fine. Then she showed us the bedrooms. And Nancy said, which bathroom do we use? And Leanne said, well, I don't think you can use the bathroom. The bathroom in the hallway that was near the bedrooms, we can't use because her housemates use it and they won't be comfortable sharing with us. And then the bathroom that she uses, she doesn't want to share with us because COVID. But I didn't really care because I'm going to stay in the bus anyway. I had already decided that and I have a toilet in there. But Nancy, she's in a car. So she has a porta potty that she takes out. What's she going to do? Just take it out in a suburban driveway? She can come in the bus, of course, but there's a big difference between sharing someone's bucket and sharing a flush toilet. Oh, wow, this bridge, it looks like it's an open drawbridge, like it's so steep, but then you get on it, it's not that steep. It's beautiful. I mean, she didn't do it on purpose. She just forgot. I mean, how much experience do any of us have hosting guests during a pandemic? Pretty much none. I have none. But if we had known, then we probably would have stopped like an hour earlier because we were really tired, and we would have stopped someplace like a rest stop or a truck stop or a 24-hour grocery where Nancy could have had access to a bathroom. But nobody died, you know? She just didn't think about it. Not a big deal. And then, so after we got settled in, we sat on the back patio. Leanne has a beautiful house, really old, beautiful house. And we sat on the back patio and just chatted. And Leanne told us about her trip she's about to go on, where there's going to be three people in her van. I don't think I could take that. Oh. Wow. Wild horses. Feral horses. And now they've come over here to say hi. Hi, horsies. We're at Assateague National Seashore, which is famous for its herd of wild/feral horses. There's a lot of mystery around how they got here. And I'm not going to talk about it today because I'm going to make a whole video about that. They told us we have to stay 40 feet away from them, but nobody seems to have told them they have to stay 40 feet away from us. I've just been watching them out the window, and they're so beautiful. I don't get to see horses very often because I'm really allergic, to be totally honest, so I don't really ride or anything, but I love them. So I saw this place in the AARP magazine. And I just went online and made a reservation, and then COVID hit. So it's been questionable whether we were actually going to get to come. And they reopened like 3 days ago. If they had reopened 3 days later, we wouldn't even be able to be here. As soon as I made the reservation, though, I called Leanne because she lives near here. And I thought, you know, we had fun camping together before, so I figured we'd have fun. She seemed really into it. And then after COVID hit and we would talk on the phone about whether it was going to happen, you know, whether they're going to open or not. And a couple times she said to me, are you sure you want me to come? And then finally she says, let me know what day you want me to visit. And I just thought, that's weird, because it seemed clear that she was going to be coming for the whole time, you know. And then all of a sudden, when do you want me to visit you? But I know that she has a plan to come back here with some other friends 4th of July weekend. So maybe she's just... she probably won't stay the whole time. Actually, she was supposed to park here at the camp spot, and Nancy was going to set up her tent and then drop her car in the parking lot because she could only have two vehicles. But Leanne said, oh, no, I'll go park in the parking lot. So that's what she did. But she said that she wanted to make us lunch. So I haven't seen her in a while, but I think she was going for a walk on the beach. I'm sure she'll be back here by then, though. See, this is the table they set up, and there's these cupboards underneath. You put your coolers and stuff underneath because otherwise they're going to get it, you know. And the signs on the table say a fed horse is a dead horse. So I don't want a dead horse. Ooh, look at her. She's making a beeline for the table. Nancy, what's on the table?
Nothing.
Okay.
No food. That's gas.
Well, hopefully it doesn't like that.
I don't think there's any food in there. Everything's already under the table.
The door's not shut under the table?
It's on the other side of the table.
Okay.
Get out of here. You're kind of making me nervous there, buddy.
I think he's awesome. I have to say I am super impressed with Captain because, I mean, he's just chill, and I don't think I've ever used that word to describe him. I don't know what just happened. I mean, I know what just happened, but what just happened? Leanne is gone. She stormed off. She came back, and I said, oh, you're back for lunch. And she said, no, I just had my lunch in the van over in the parking lot. Okay. She's the one who said she wanted to cook lunch for us. I don't care if she cooks lunch or not. I didn't even say anything because I don't care. But why would you say, oh, I want to cook lunch for you guys, and then eat your lunch alone in the parking lot? But anyway, I didn't say anything. We sit down, we're chatting, and, you know, I was expressing frustration. I was probably expressing a lot of frustration. I was probably expressing an annoying amount of frustration with this, with YouTube, because, you know, things are not going the way I want them to go. It's not growing as quick as I want it to go, and I found something I love, and I want it to love me back, so I care. Okay. So I'm frustrated. So I was expressing my frustration, and I really wasn't even so much talking to Leanne. I was talking to Nancy, and all of a sudden Leanne jumps up and says, I can't do this. I can't do this. This is exactly why I can't do this. And Nancy and I went, can't do what? She says, I can't have all this negativity in my head. And you know what? For my own self-care, for my mental health, I need to get away from you guys after how you treated me last night. And I'm thinking, okay, what was last night? And she says, well, you didn't care about me at all. You weren't asking me any questions about, you didn't care how things were going for me. You didn't care what I was up to. And I had to take that in because I can be kind of on my own train, right? You know, and I can be oblivious. So I took it in, and then I remembered, like, I know all these details about the trip she's going to go on with her housemates, the three of them in the van driving to the West Coast. And, you know, we talked about that whole thing. I know about her neighbors on either side. I know what she planted in her yard, and I don't even garden. So it seems like I took in a lot, considering the whole conversation was like 20 minutes. You can tell me that I'm negative, or, you know, that I'm boring because I keep talking about YouTube, or like that I keep complaining about the same thing, whatever. You can tell me any of that. Yeah, I have to own that. But this woman's going to tell me I'm inconsiderate who didn't even think through where these women were going to poop. But she doesn't even really wait to have a conversation about that. She's just, boom, she's gone. When it came to the bathroom thing, I just tried to meet her where she was. She said that she just didn't think of it because of COVID, and I tried to meet her where she was, and that's just not something she's willing to do for me, obviously, so she's gone. If she thinks that was negative, it's a good thing she didn't see the video I made at the beach earlier today. Yeah, I'm not going to show that to anybody. Well, I'll show you a little piece, but that's it.
I think this might be my last video. I'm not blaming on anyone. I'm not going to blame it on YouTube. I just think nobody wants
self-pity is a beautiful thing. Nancy made us this amazing meal over the campfire, and then look who showed up.
Every time a star falls down, you lose a little piece of mind. Feels like sinking through the ground like quicksand when you try to fight. Right now, things are looking dark and dangerous, always creeping up, but you see, things are gonna be alright. We're all staring at the same moon. We're all crazy fighters and fools, and we run in circles when we could be flying. Aim up, aim up, aim up, and shoot the moon.
Leanne and I exchanged a couple texts. Doesn't really matter. But when I look back, it kind of feels like she was never really planning to be part of this thing. It's like she was trying to get me to say no to her so she wouldn't have to say no to me. I'm sad because I thought I had a friend there. It's okay. She's not wrong. What she said is not wrong. I mean, I can go dark. I can go deep dark. But inside, I'm a freaking firefly. Firefly sometimes, but when I do, you know what brings me back? Making a video. That's how I know this is gonna work, because, you know, feel bad, make a video, feel better. Of course, then I post it. I'm not getting thousands of views, but you're here. Nancy's here, and she is a great cook. That's something you should really look for in a camp buddy. Okay, I'm gonna go make some more. You watch this. And next time I'm going to tell you about the horses. Good night, friend.